with some commentary with my friend and this prophet.
The needs of our planet were greater than she could supply.
It's the Eternal Commentary, right? That's the name.
Yes.
Live. It's got to be live, too.
I know. It is. It's on air right now.
So we went but I mean, you should just put that in the... Oh, okay. Well, I'll start it off. I'll be like,
But the distance gave way to a movement.
Like, hey guys, it's Endless Prophet here, your host of the new show, known as Eternal Commentary. Okay?
Yes.
I'm writing a description and putting a name.
I'm already in the game, so...
They want absolutely yeah, no, you're already streaming. I'm just putting in some they raid colonies, take stuff before I start.
So should we just make a new YouTube channel for this?
They use their fleet what?
To lock us commentaries? Should we make like a side YouTube channel together for commentaries?
Actually, that's a great idea. Holy shit.
Why didn't I think of that?
Yeah, that's a good idea, kid. Holy crap, we should do that. But first episode will be on my channel, okay? And then we'll start a whole new channel. Yeah, and on yours. But then we'll start a whole new channel that we'll share. Called, Eternal.
Yeah. Okay? Called Eternal Commentaries.
Yeah.
With Darndest Donuts and, Endless Prophet.
Yeah. Copy 1-1. One of our weapons facilities is alright. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Endless Prophet here, your host of the new show that I just created. Well, commentary. Called Eternal. So, this is the Eternal Commentary featuring my good friend Kit. Hello, Kit. Say hi.
Hey, guys. It's the Darndest Donuts.
Oh, yeah. Go check out his channel at the Darndest Donuts. YouTube.com/Darndest Donuts. That's not his URL yet, but it will be.
Actually.
So if you guys haven't noticed, my volume is turned down very low, and that's just because we're gonna do a commentary, which is when we just talk about random things and we don't necessarily talk, you know. So, we're doing this live because it's gonna be a live show. And so I'm just gonna start my game. Kit, are you gonna start yours?
I already have.
Okay, well, I'm gonna start mine. Let's skip the scene. So our first topic that Kit wanted to talk about was... What was it?
Movies.
Movies, right. So,
what movies
would
we thought
like
were good?
Begin?
Nah,
would you like
should.
To begin?
You should begin.
Okay.
Because you're the
so
host.
So, I think... Oh, well, I mean, I'm just the one who's gonna, you know, make the shows and stuff. I'm not gonna be, like, the one who starts out on everything. We both own this show.
Well, today you start out.
Yeah, we both start. Okay. So, one of the movies that I really, really enjoyed this year was actually, Rogue One. I thought it was really good. Some other people didn't. They thought it was, like, cheesy and stuff. But I thought it was pretty good. What are your thoughts?
I thought it was really good, too. Probably one of the best movies of the year, but... One of them. I'm not gonna say the best.
I think the best movie of the year, it's probably gotta go to Deadpool.
Probably. It was a pretty good movie.
Have you seen it yet?
Yes. Saw it on a plane.
Yeah. Oh, you did?
Yes.
I thought it was really funny.
It is. It's really hilarious.
I'm trying to think of some other movies that came out this year.
Assassin's Creed came out, but it wasn't that good.
I didn't think it was terrible. Oh,
I mean, it wasn't terrible.
It, it wasn't like what I expected. I expected it to be, you know, all in medieval times and everyone was...
Yeah. I didn't actually expect it
like,
to be mostly in Spanish, too.
Well, that's just to keep it, you know, realistic. You know, you wouldn't go to Spain and everyone would be speaking English, right?
Yeah. I mean, I guess that's right. I mean, that's a good idea on their part to keep it a little bit realistic in real life, for real life purposes, well,
I think the Assassin's Creed movie was more of a prologue, or a prequel to the other movies, or to the other games, rather, of Assassin's Creed. Kinda, or maybe a retelling.
Yep. It probably is. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's the best movie, I'm not gonna say it's the worst, right?
Yeah, it definitely wasn't the worst. I thought it was really good. The special effects, in my opinion, were good. The action was good. It was just kind of boring at some parts, though. There were some, parts that left me confused. Like,
they weren't in the... They weren't as assassins much. It was mostly about, like, the...
Yeah, they weren't much assassins. They were more, it was more like parkour, and they were jumping around and stabbing people and stuff, but,
Yeah, it's not like the assassins from the game. I mean, the assassins from the game are kind of parkour-ish, but...
Well, yeah, the whole, like, Assassin's Creed game, the whole thing is, like, mostly parkour, but... I mean, it was stealthy, too. There was... a really good element of stealth in that game, and being detected, you failed a mission, and I didn't see much stealth in the movie.
Yeah. Stay alert, we're not clear. And it wasn't in the assassin's eyes at all.
It was mostly,
in this guy named Cal's eyes. You know?
Yeah.
Like, why?
Yeah, I thought it was mostly gonna be the assassin.
It's like they say it's Assassin's Creed. Well, it's kind of based on Assassin's Creed, but it's like not the Assassin's Creed.
It's more based on it than actual Assassin's Creed. It seems like more of a retelling of the Assassin's Creed story. Hold on, I'm gonna drink right now. I'm thirsty. I just came home from school.
I got home from school a few minutes ago.
Yeah. You know, definitely worth going and seeing it in the theaters.
I'm not gonna lie, I actually liked it.
Yeah, I liked it. I thought it was good. Like you said, it's more inspired by Assassin's Creed than actual Assassin's Creed. And how the trailer portrayed it out to be was,
gonna be like, awesome type thing.
Well, not necessarily that, but more of like,
like, they wanted to make it look really cool, and, like, it wasn't as cool as we thought it was gonna be, you know?
Well, I'm thinking more of, like, it was all gonna be in medieval times, or not necessarily medieval, but the time period that the assassin was in. It was all gonna be the assassin, not just the one, main
character. One guy named Cal.
Yeah. But I definitely would recommend it if any of you guys want to go see it. It's definitely a well thought out, well, not necessarily well thought out, but well put together movie that, you know, it was really interesting. I enjoyed it.
Same. I enjoyed it. It was just, some of the time I was just like, why? Why did they make it?
Yeah. It's like, some parts were not necessary.
Okay.
Oh, I just got a message from my phone that says that you were recording the Darndest, or the Eternal. Okay, hold on. So, what about Star Wars? What do you think about Star Wars?
The movies or just Rogue One?
Yeah, Rogue One.
I liked it. I mean...
Yeah, I liked it. What?
What did you say? What were you about to say?
I said, Some people thought that Rogue One was like cheesier than.
You already said
than
that.
Like the. Yeah, that's. I thought you. That's. Okay, never mind.
Yeah,
you were just. Okay. So, what did you not like about Rogue One? Because there was a few things that I didn't like.
What didn't you like?
I just didn't like the fact that, you know, one of the things I like about Star Wars is, like, the lightsabers and the Jedis, and there wasn't any Jedis or lightsabers, except at the end, where Darth Vader was stabbing the dude with his lightsaber.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot to say, spoiler alerts, for people who haven't seen these movies. So, yeah. Okay. Let's continue. So, I also didn't like how they killed off every single character.
Yeah, they killed off most of the characters.
They killed off all the important ones.
Yeah, like all the important ones. Like that guy who was running the airship, the Rogue One ship.
Well, I know how in war there's a lot of casualties, but I mean, the fact that every single one of the main characters died, and it was all at that one last part, I didn't like that part. I thought it was over the top.
Yeah.
I don't know, what didn't you like about it?
I didn't like that everybody died at that one moment.
And yeah, then, it's like how, they just all died by the Death Star.
They all just died by the Death Star,
and then you don't
see. Yeah, nothing really happened that was, like, except you see, like, the supposedly new Princess Leia.
What is Raya? Yeah, you see Princess Leia, but she's only CG. She's not like Carrie Fisher. She's CG.
Yeah, well, Carrie Fisher did die. Settlement Defense
Front doesn't make demand. Yeah, she died, but she didn't die during the production of the movie. The production of the movie was probably started in, like, way before, probably even the seventh one was released. They probably started back in, like, 2013.
For Rogue One?
Yeah, for Rogue One. It takes a lot to make a movie, especially with all the special effects.
Who else knows about this? I think they started back in last year, like right after, what was that other Star Wars movie that just came out?
The seventh one?
Yeah.
The Force Awakens?
Yeah, The Force Awakens.
I don't think they did it that late in... after
well, they
the
did. They
other
did.
One came out. That,
they did finish
that'd
up
be
the.
A stupid move on their part.
They did the second part of The Force Awakens already, though, right before Carrie Fisher died. They're politicians,
Reyes. What of the Force Awakens?
Yeah, the second part.
The second? You mean part? There's a part two to The Force Awakens?
Yes.
I didn't know that The Force Awakens had... I thought it was going to be the eighth one that comes out.
It isn't.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's like the ninth or tenth.
Okay. The ninth or tenth one is coming out?
The ninth one.
No, they haven't even come out with an eight, dude.
Yeah, they have, because Force Awakens.
Rogue One wasn't the eighth. Rogue One was it wasn't even a Star Wars, like, an actual, well, it was a Star Wars movie, but it wasn't, like, canon. Well, it's canon, but it's not, like, important to the regular storyline. It's just a detailing of how the Rebellion got the plan to the Death Star. So it's not technically an eighth, it's just a prequel to the fourth one.
Yeah.
So the eighth one is gonna come out.
Next year. This year's this Christmas.
Year. Yeah, this year's Christmas, yeah. Service has its perks. We got a plane to catch.
Yeah. The one thing I didn't understand about Rogue One was why they would like make it so like made it up instead of like follow the Star Wars story.
They did follow the Star Wars story.
Not
in the
fully.
Story. Like, what was the flaw?
Like, the only thing that I recognized from every other Star Wars movie was, like, the C-3PO droid and R2-D2 droid. And then Princess Leia from the other one.
What about the Death Star? What about Darth Vader? What
well,
about
those,
the evil
I mean,
Emperor
Darth
guy?
Vader, you never
they
saw the
new
evil...
That's just new stuff.
Yeah, I mean,
they
didn't
add
follow
new stuff
the Star Wars
movie.
Story from... From other points of view, like it, like they never ever talked about like Jen Erso or anybody else. In fact, from
that's because it wasn't important because they died.
Yeah.
And he was an Imperial scientist, so they didn't really like him. And they wanted to tell the story of how the rebellion got the plans to the Death Star, anyways, because in the fourth one. The people were just left like, how did they get the plans to the Death Star in the first place? It's like they start out, and they're Princess Leia's trying to deliver these plans through an R2 droid. You know.
Hey Jason, how do you turn down the game volume?
You pause it, then you go to options, and then you go to audio options, and then master volume, or just regular volume.
Okay.
So I have mine turned down just because it's excuse me.
Like all the way down?
Not all the way, but just partially. Well, like, have it partially so you can partially hear it, you know?
Yeah, so we can know the story, but... So, any other movies that came out this year that you saw?
There was Civil War.
That was an okay
Captain
movie.
America. Yeah, that was an okay one. I didn't like it as much as the other Captain America movies, but I didn't think it was bad.
Yeah.
It was definitely better than Batman v Superman. That one was terrible.
Yeah.
Did you see Batman vs. Superman?
No, I didn't. I heard it was crap, though.
It was garbage.
Yeah.
It was probably the worst movie of the year. Not even, like... Exaggerating, it's probably the worst.
Yeah, I mean, the Batman game that came out before it was probably the same.
The Batman game, like, what, Arkham Knight or whatever?
No, they came out with another
Which
one.
Which Batman game?
Oh, no, it was
Arkham
an app
City?
Game. No, it was
oh,
an
it was
app
an
game.
App game?
Yeah, it was garbage. It was based off Batman. Batman v Superman.
Most app games are bad, except for Roblox.
No. Come here. Stupid cat. Get off. Okay. Yeah. I mean... I can't say that... It was a...
Well, like, speaking of, What did you... Okay, how about Deadpool? Okay, because we were talking about that at first, and we never did continue the topic.
Yeah.
So, what about Deadpool? What did you like about Deadpool?
Some of it I really did not understand. I mean... I didn't understand how or why he was so ugly. Like a...
Because he got mutated, dude. He looks like an onion.
Kind of.
You mean an avocado?
Yeah.
That's how they explain it in the movie. That's how the fat guy does, or not the fat guy, the ugly nerd guy. Like, you look like an ugly avocado had sex with an uglier avocado. And he goes, thank you.
That was one of the funny parts, I have to say.
Did you actually see it?
Yes, I did.
Because if that was one of the only funny parts,
I said that was one of the
sad.
Funny parts. I said that was a funny
part.
Well,
that was like
for
one
me.
Of the. That was like one of the.
That was a, one
like,
of the beginning
cheesy
things.
Comedy lines.
That was a beginning line
yeah.
too.
Not really. Well, that was like after,
it was after Deadpool. He was mutated. After he was mutated.
Yeah, after he was mutated and he goes to see his friend.
But,
I forgot his name. I haven't seen that movie in a while.
Same.
You wanna know what's ironic?
What?
The same guy who plays Green Lantern in the Green Lantern movie plays, Deadpool.
Deadpool.
And Green Lantern is DC. Yeah, like, Green Lantern is DC and Deadpool is Marvel.
I'm not gonna lie that they did have a hint or two to the
to Green Lantern?
Yeah. Cause, you
they
know
may
how,
have, I don't
You know how Green Lantern, the guy loved the weapons and stuff?
Yeah.
Weapons? Yeah. He loved, weapons in...
Deadpool?
Yeah. And,
well, I mean, if you think of...
Yeah, it was...
And Green Lantern's only weapon is his little ring that he can make dildos out of.
Uh-huh.
But, I think one of the parts I didn't like about Deadpool was just, it was kind of slow-paced, and it didn't seem long enough.
It really didn't. I mean, in some of the trailers, it was... There were some things...
Like, I think most of the movie was, like, backstory telling, and then, like, the other... Like, part... more than half the movie was just backstory, and then... The other parts were just like,
Yeah.
The other parts. It was a very small part where he was actually doing stuff as himself, just regularly.
Oh, crap. Yeah. I mean... Remember how he, only had, like, 9 bullets left and he went... 1? Two.
Yeah, he was like counting his bullets.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
And then the guy who shoots him in the butt, he wastes like 3 bullets on his dead body.
Yeah, and he's like, oops, only have one left. Only have like one, he said, oh, only have one left. Or something like that. It was hilarious.
Yeah, that was probably one of my favorite parts. Or my favorite part was, like, when he shot the dead body, the guy who shot him in the asshole, he shot his dead body, like, a whole bunch of times.
5 times.
Wasted a bunch of bullets, and he was all like,
because he was really mad.
Stupid, 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 worth it. Or something like
stupid,
that.
Stupid, bad Deadpool, stupid Deadpool.
Or he was like, stupid decision, worth it. Or when he gets that triple headshot with the Deagle. Oh god, I sound like a Call of Duty player. But, he gets the triple headshot with that Desert Eagle. He's like, oh, I'm so touching myself to that.
And then he sniffs the smoke.
Yeah, he sniffs the smoke, and he's like, I'm touching myself tonight, or something like that. Some kind of sexual innuendo.
Yeah.
But what do you expect, man? It's Deadpool.
It really is.
But it's fun. It was. I thought it was pretty.
It
funny.
Was hilarious. I mean, it had to be one of the. No, it had to be the second best movie of the year, or
yeah,
the
best. Maybe
what,
I don't know.
What
I think
was
the best?
Best.
The best. That's a hard one. I don't know. That's a hard one. What do you think was the best?
I actually think that most of the movies that I saw were okay. I'm not gonna say there's a best, there isn't a worst either for me.
I'm trying to think. There was a movie that came out that I thought was really good. Was it The Martian? Did The Martian come out in 2016? Or did it come out, in 2015? I think it came out,
2015, I think.
Yeah, I think it came out in 2015. I was about to say, because that would be the best movie of the year. That one was good.
Yeah. Did you see the movie Inferno?
Inferno? No.
Me neither. But,
What is it about? Is it like Dante's Inferno?
Yeah, how do you know?
I don't know, I was just thinking Inferno, Dante's Inferno.
How did you know about
Dante? So it actually is Dante's Inferno.
How did you know about Dante's Inferno?
Well, I used to have I have a friend named Dante, so whenever I think of, I just knew that there was like a book written about him or something like that. I heard about Dante's Inferno, the book.
Yeah.
So. But I think my favorite movie, to be honest, it probably would have to be Star Wars.
It was...
Just because I like Star Wars so much.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't deny, Star Wars is just great.
What were some of the worst movies you've seen this year?
Oh, jeez. Batman v Superman, Suicide Squad.
I haven't seen Suicide Squad, but it sounded horrible.
It was just terrible. It was bad.
I mean, I'm still probably going to see it, just get my own opinion of it, but...
Actually, let me look up a list of movies that came out in 2016.
Yeah.
I'm just looking it up online. Wait, did the Fantastic Four come out in 2016?
I think it came out 2 years ago.
Like the new Fantastic Four.
Yeah. Yeah, I watched it in 2016 on DVD, so probably 2015,
2014. Oh, wait, no, I know the worst movie. Ghostbusters. Or no, the Angry Birds movie, dude.
Yeah, the Angry Birds movie. I haven't seen it, but I'm gonna say that I'm probably not gonna see it.
Or Sausage Party, dude.
Why? Why would they do that?
I don't know. Or Warcraft. You know Warcraft?
Yeah, I didn't see that movie. I like the game, it's okay, but...
You like World of Warcraft?
Kind of. It's an okay game.
I hate that movie. Oh, there's also Independence Day, dude.
Yeah, Independence Day was... No, that was 2015.
Mm-mm. Nope. Came out this year, because I remember I saw it on my birthday.
Then why was it... Why
Independence
is it on
Day
DVD?
Resurgence.
Why is it on DVD already?
Because it came out over the summer. I'm sure Rogue One's going to be on DVD soon, dude.
Yeah. I'm not gonna say that.
But. Did you see Independence Day?
Yes, I saw it on DVD.
Did you think it was good?
I liked it. I mean, I saw the old Independence Day.
Yeah, I liked the old one better because the new one seemed like more action packed than suspicious and mysterious like the older one. The older one, it was like.
Like, what is happening?
The humans stand no chance. Yeah, like, the humans stand no chance against these aliens. And then, in the new one, it's like the humans have the alien technology and they're using it against
So,
the
why would they... Why would they... I thought it was an okay movie.
I'm not saying it was bad. It was really good, in my opinion. But, I'm just saying, like...
Maybe third, fourth best?
It seemed way too easy for the humans. And they kind of knew that, I think, when they were scripting the movie, so they made it, like, super, super, like...
I mean, I did like how his mom had to die, you know? Like, you know how his mom died?
Well, you mean the black dude? Yeah, the black guy?
Yeah, Will Smith's, son in the movie.
Like, the guy, Will Smith. Yeah, his son? Yeah, I know,
his son in the movie.
What I didn't like was the whole fact that it was just the aliens, they were drilling into the Earth's core. And, like, that's the whole danger, was that they were drilling into the Earth's core. And, like...
I mean, personally, I thought the aliens were going to try to steal the Earth's core.
I think they were more likely going to try to, like, you know how they can mind control humans, kind of?
Yeah.
Like, they would stick their tentacles all up in their butt or something like that, and they could mind control them or whatever. I think they were just going to do that to all the humans and make them slaves, but no, they were just going to drill into their core and blow it up. Like, I think it made it so that it seemed more like the aliens were going to win, and it wasn't so easy for the humans, but still. Now it's just, it seems way too easy for the humans to win.
Yeah, it was... I'm not gonna say that...
I definitely liked it, though.
Yeah. I'm not gonna say it wasn't cheesy in some ways. Same with the older one, but... Like, how could aliens ever...
Yeah, there were some parts where it was cheesy. But other parts, there was...
Same with the older one, too, you know?
Yeah. I didn't like the, you know that one, like, wimpy character who was talking to the big buff dude, and he was like, teach me your ways, and the buff dude had, like, the two katana, or two machetes, or whatever?
Yeah.
Like, I thought that part was kind of cool. Yeah. But I liked the return of characters, too. Like the old president guy, and then there was, God, I'm forgetting all these actors. The guy, the nerdy scientist guy.
Oh, yeah, the guy who plays,
David, the guy who plays David.
That's, yeah, that's the and there's name. This other
he's
guy.
Not kidding, like 40.
Yeah, there's this other guy who plays...
He's in Jurassic Park. Right?
Yeah, he was in Jurassic Park, but... He was also in...
But I'm not sure...
Oh, no, not David, but, But you know that guy who plays, that robotic dude in Star Trek?
Yeah, I know that guy. The old guy?
Yeah, it's like, he was in there too.
Yeah, I'm forgetting all these actors' names, dude. I'm drawing a blank, dude. Anyways, so... What other movies did you like? Actually, no, that's kind of like most of the movies... from the series. I can't think of any more, because I looked up a list. Excuse me, holy crap. So how about we just segment from the movie? How about we talk about some older movies?
Or games, whatever.
Or games, yeah. It's like, what games do you want to talk about?
What games are there? Or any...
There's a lot of games.
What like have you been interested in?
What have I been interested in?
Yeah.
Like, games-wise, or what?
Anything-wise, I mean.
Well, I've been building my computer.
I mean, other than computers.
Well, I mean, you're kind of narrowing it down. You're just like, what have you been interested in doing? What have I been doing? And I said, I've been building my computer.
Okay, how about... What have you been doing that is like? Okay, have you your science project for? Do you have to do a science project?
We don't have science projects in high school. I haven't had to do one of those since like
8th grade.
7th grade. 7th grade. I didn't have to do one in 8th grade.
Yeah, I had to do it in 8th grade, but I'm not going to say that
You're in 8th grade right now, right?
7th grade.
Oh, you're in 7th grade?
No.
I didn't know that. 8th grade.
No, I'm in 8th.
Oh, okay. You're bad at sarcasm, so I couldn't try.
No, I'm just really, I didn't... Yeah, I just didn't say the right words.
Yeah, I know you didn't.
So, do you think we should talk about politics or something?
Politics? Like, what about politics? Like Trump?
I mean, what do you think of some of the things he's done, like some of his choices?
I don't even think he's done anything yet. His inauguration is
tomorrow.
It's today, actually. Oh, wait, no, yeah, it's tomorrow. Wait, hold on, I could look it up. I'll ask you. What day is Trump's inauguration? Alright, it is tomorrow. Okay. So, I don't think he's done it yet.
I mean, what do you think of some of the things he's going to do?
He's planning on doing?
Yeah.
I'm gonna spark controversy.
Do you think they're good choices or bad choices or...
Hold on, my controller is really bugging out.
Your mic?
No, just my controller. Like, the movements are all weird. I'm gonna pause it for a second and see if it'll fix it. But I'm gonna be completely honest. There are some things that I totally 100% agree on with Trump with, and that's immigration. And I know this is gonna spark a lot of controversy. I am sorry, okay? But this is America, and I'm allowed to have my views.
Freedom
on
of speech.
And I have freedom of speech. So you can dislike this video. You can, you know, do whatever you want. I don't care. This is America. I have freedom of speech. I agree with him on immigration because there are so many homeless people and so many people in need of jobs, and those jobs are being taken by people who are not citizens of this country, illegal immigrants.
Some
now
of them.
the whole wall thing, yeah. Some of them are immigrants. Illegal immigrants came here illegally, but
I mean, some of them are taken over by that.
Yeah. Well, I'm just talking about like I think it's ridiculous that people who came here illegally without a passport with like. Without paying, you know, and they get to take our jobs and people for the hardworking American man, you know?
Well, now it's man and woman.
Well, I'm just, you know, saying in general.
Yeah.
You know, we call it mankind, so.
Some people are saying, like, why don't we call it humankind? And...
Well, we do call it humankind, but we can also call it mankind.
Easier just to say man.
Yeah, it's easier just to say man. And plus, you can't spell human without man. Like, I'm not saying it. Oh my god, I'm just sparking up a whole bunch of controversy. I'm gonna annoy a bunch of triggered little feminazis, but, like, it's whatever, you know? Anyway, I don't agree on his stance on the wall. I think that is...
Let's build a wall.
I think that's ridiculous, in my opinion. That's just absurd. We're going to be China. We're the Great Wall of America.
I mean...
Yeah, that's ridiculous, in my opinion. It's like, just make Border Patrol better, okay? We don't need to build a big, like, what, 100-foot wall? Is that what he's planning on making?
Yeah, and how would he pay for it? It would be way more than whatever he has for money.
You
know?
Sure? I mean, Trump lives in an apartment the size of a mansion that has gold. He has, like, a gold toilet, and it's just all, it's a bunch of gold inside.
How do we know that?
I don't think he has any problem with money.
I mean, he doesn't have any problem with money, but...
He runs his own business.
It would probably take half, most of the money he has.
Yeah, it would well, not most of it. Building walls don't take all that much money. At most, it would probably be about... I'm guessing $500 mil. Yeah, 500 mil, maybe. But, like, I think it's absolutely ridiculous that he's gonna build a wall.
Yeah, build a wall. Yeah, how about we build this wall and keep every Mexican out? I think that part... He is kind of racist, you know? In some ways,
but I mean...
In some ways, there are...
He got, like, what, 14% of the Latino vote? That's not a very small percentage. That's over 10%. And that Mexican lady who jumped up on stage and started saying that she loved Donald Trump, who was not a paid actor, believe me, she wasn't.
Who?
Just, you could look it up. It's this, like, Mexican lady who jumped up. And she said that she loved Trump.
Yeah, you know the, that his appointed school person?
Appointed school person? What do you mean by that?
Like the person who runs the board for school, in Congress and crap?
Yeah?
Well, you know how she, said some guns in school and she made a point about, like, how... There's this small school who had a gun in the school to keep away grizzly bears. Well, they checked in with the school. Yeah, they checked in with the school. And guess what?
What?
There's no guns on the school property. There's not even a grizzly bear. There wasn't even a grizzly bear.
Oh. Why did they need a gun then? There was no grizzly bear.
No, there wasn't even any gun.
Yeah, I know, but like you said, they needed a gun for a grizzly bear.
And then, she said there was a grizzly bear. And they said there was no guns or grizzly bears near them. So.
Oh. That must have just been a mistake on her part.
Or she's just a. Idiot, you know?
I don't know. I think Trump is. People are saying that, like, oh, Trump, it's gonna be the end of the world, but you know, people have said that about other presidents before.
We need to build, we need to build all those, like, bunkers to keep them out of our lives. Yeah, they did that with
America's
the whole...
America's ruined. Not our president. Not our president. No, it's just like... It's ridiculous, dude.
I mean, I agree with you there. Some of the things people have said about him... I mean, I'm not going to agree that he is probably the worst or the best president. But he is our president.
I think he's going to do what America needs. America has been in some deep shit recently, and Donald Trump is a businessman, and he knows what he's doing, even though he's three times, but you know, he's gotten up from his bankrupt. Asshole, no. He is an asshole. But you can't change that.
Yeah, I mean...
You know, it's more about what he does than what he says.
Yeah. I think you're right. I mean...
Definitely better than Hillary Bitchface. I'd rather have Stalin than Hitler. I'd rather have Stalin than Hillary. Hitler. I mistook. Sorry, I mistook Hillary for Hitler.
You bad, bad person.
No, I think Hitler's better. I'm kidding. But on a serious note, though, Hillary's bullshit. I would rather have Stalin. In some ways, dude, she's mentally ill.
Some ways.
She's just
I actually found out Trump's phone number.
You found Trump's phone number? How did you do that?
I had to do it for a school project. We had to find elected officials' phone numbers or emails and stuff. And I found his phone number.
Oh, like his business phone number.
No,
like
his phone number.
Why would they just have his cell phone number out on the internet? I think it's just his business number, dude.
No, his house number type thing.
His house? No, dude, that's his business number. Believe me, they wouldn't have his house number out on the internet, or people would be prank calling it or using it to order pizzas. You know. So I'm pretty sure it was just his business number.
But it showed him on a cell phone, so.
Well, anyways, enough
who
about.
Who knows?
I'm pretty sure it's his business number.
It probably is, but still, it's a way of contacting him.
Yeah, it's a way of contacting his business, rather. And I'm pretty sure people have left some pretty triggered messages. Whatever, they're just a bunch of pussies. Oh, and I got a question. Do you agree with gun control?
In some ways, no.
Well, like, what do you mean in some ways? Like, because I could argue every way that gun control is BS.
Having back checks, I think that's a good idea on some people.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, I agree with background checks, but I mean, like, do you believe that we should outlaw assault weapons or outlaw automatics or...
I mean, heavy, light machine guns, yes. You know,
that's our right, dude. If we want to have light machine guns, so be it. So be it.
Well,
dude.
I agree with that. Why? I mean, personally, I probably wouldn't own one. You know?
You sure, dude? Are you sure about that? Would you really not own a light machine gun? Be honest with me.
Maybe an saw, but
maybe you mean a M249 squad automatic weapon?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could see, but what Hillary wants to do is ban not only assault weapons and automatics, but the regular guns that we have as of now.
Like pistols?
Like 22 rifles and pistols, like all guns, basically. See, that's what happened if Hillary would become president.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, there are...
You see, if Trump was president, you know, we would have all of the guns that we wanted. That's our right to own guns. And if people don't want to, you know, if the politicians want to ban automatics, that's our right. They're banning part of our rights. That's like saying, you know, you can still have your freedom of speech, but we're going to make it so you can't say certain things, but you can say some other stuff, you know?
Yeah, I mean...
Like, there's some things you can say and some things you can't, but we're not saying that you can't, that, you know, you can't talk or anything. That's basically how gun control is right now. It's just like, you know, you can still own guns, but there's certain ones that you can't get, and I think that's BS. I think you should have whatever gun you want, whenever you want. And right now, they limit you to one gun per month.
Really?
To be able to purchase, yeah.
That's strange.
To that I say, are you retarded?
Are you nuts?
I mean, yeah, are you nuts? It's like, people who really, really enjoy guns, and people who really, really like guns, they... You know, they want to have an assortment of guns, and if you can only buy one every month, especially people who are just getting into guns, you know, one day, like, if you're just getting into guns, you turn 18, right? This is a scenario. You turn 18. and you buy your first gun, let's say it's a bolt-action rifle, and you say, man, I really like this bolt-action rifle, you know. I think I'd use it someday if I go hunting or whatever, but what if I want a gun for personal protection, and I don't want to return this bolt-action rifle, I kind of want to go get another. We've got to wait a whole another month just to get, you know, the personal defense weapon that you want.
Personally, I think they should change the pistol age limit for buying to 18.
Why? I think it's good the way it is now, you know, because there's a lot of immature 18-year-olds, and plus, it's concealable. You can conceal you can conceal a pistol, so an 18-year-old.
Maybe that's a good thing that they...
Yeah, most 18-year-olds are in high school, and if they can carry a pistol,
some are,
you know,
some are in
they could go into a high school. Well, yeah, some. But, you know, they could go into a school and shoot some people up.
Yeah, and that would be horrible.
So, I'm not saying that they can't have that gun. But
well,
I'm just
they can
that
own it,
age...
it's just
so
that
I'm...
their parents have to buy it for them.
Own it, but it would be
I
in
mean,
their
they
parents'
can buy
name.
It. They can buy it, but they would have to have it in their parents' name.
Yeah, exactly. And they can't carry it, around. You know, well, I guess that's a given. You can't really carry guns around in public unless you have a permit.
Yeah.
And in order to get a permit, I think you have to be 21 to have a concealed carry permit. But I think it's BS that you can, like, conceal carry a shotgun. Or not that. I mean, it's BS that you can't conceal carry, like, a sawed-off shotgun.
Like, I think it's BS that sawed-off shotguns are illegal.
Well, like, depending on if you saw off the back and make it into a pistol shotgun, you could break your hand.
You mean that's a sawed-off shotgun?
Yeah, you could break your bones.
Yeah, you could if you were a small child and if you were holding it one-handed.
I mean, unless you're holding
it... grown men...
One hand on, like, the... One hand on the back, one hand in the front area, and go bang without the... That would be... stupid, but...
It doesn't have that much recoil, dude. Because it's...
Wait, do you mean a double-barreled or...
It's gonna have... Yeah, well, any kind of shotgun, really, sawed off. Like, really, any kind of shotgun, if you think about it, you know, if you're a grown man and you hold it one-handed and you shoot it, yeah, it's gonna have a lot of recoil, and it yet may break your bone if you're holding it wrong.
Yeah.
Nope, my dad has shot one-handed, sawed off, before they were illegal. When he was 21,
nice.
Didn't break his hand. He said it hurt, it jerked up his wrist a lot, but you can still shoot it. And I think it's going to have less recoil because it's going to be weighing your hand down more because it's just this big chunk of metal and wood right in front of you. And when you shoot it and it recoils, it's going to be so heavy that it's not going to recoil as much.
Yeah. There are some...
Stocks are more for accuracy.
Do you... I'm just saying, but... Do you think that there are should be some... ways that... some guns should be illegal, like rocket launchers and stuff?
No, dude, because those are... That's... You know, if you manufacture a gun, you know... That's a gun. That you should be allowed to have it. It's
yeah.
with a car. It's basically the same as a car, you know? When someone runs over someone else with a car, you're gonna blame the person or the car, you know? And if someone wants to have a rocket launcher and go blow some things up in his backyard, let him have it. It's fun.
Yeah.
Okay? So, like, would you pass up the opportunity to go blow something up with a rocket launcher that's safe?
Heck no. I wouldn't pass up that.
Exactly.
I would probably say, heck yeah.
Dude. I want to go blow something up.
Yeah.
And that's our American free, that's our right to have guns. And I think that any gun that has ever been manufactured, you should have.
Is there any, do you think we should talk about any other topics as well?
I don't know. What other topics do you think? I'm just thinking of, like, because we started off at top at politics, or we started off at movies, then we went on to politics. Hold on, my throat is really dry. I'm going to pause the game, and I'm going to go make some tea, but I'm still going to be talking, okay?
Yeah.
I'm a little sick today. Anyways, so... But I do think that there should be permits for certain guns. Like, I'm not saying ban them, I'm saying that there should be permits, though. It's a better alternative to banning them. Just, you know, have a permit for, say, explosives, or a permit for automatics, or a permit for assault rifles.
Yeah. So, what's the best game of the year?
Game of the year?
Yeah.
Dang, that's a hard one. There's a lot of good games that came out.
You're going. You're.
Library and see.
You're choppy and stuff.
Oh, that's because I'm getting further and further away from the PlayStation.
Okay, so.
I was making some tea.
Okay.
So
what were
game
the games
of the year,
you said?
Game of the year.
Modern Warfare.
I haven't figured out any games yet.
Modern Warfare.
I think that'd be up there. To be honest, probably Doom, actually.
I haven't played Doom that much.
It's really good. So, Doom, Modern Warfare Remastered. That's about it.
Yeah.
I think those two games probably highlight 2016 in the gaming. My throat is really dry, so.
Yeah.
Reinforcing the lunar gateway. I'm a little sick, too.
That sucks.
So what we were talking... Oh, yeah, guns. So, I think the reason
Jason,
why most people... What?
Do you know where to find the Banshee?
Banshee. In Infinite Warfare?
Yeah.
Probably on the last mission.
I tried. I can't find it there. What about the Ballista?
You beat the game already?
Yes. What about the Ballista?
The ballista. Oh, I don't know, dude. Here, can we just finish up our topic?
Yeah.
Because the whole thing was not to talk about the game that we are currently playing. Anyway, so I think that the reason most people like don't want guns is because they're scared of them. They don't know what to do when they see a gun. They're like, oh my god, it's gonna kill us all. No, I think they're idiots who don't know what they're talking about, and they're trying to take away the freedoms of other law-abiding Americans. So, personally, I don't have much respect for people who hate guns. I think that they're ignorant and stupid.
Yeah.
And they don't know what the hell they're talking about. Ooh, guns kill people! No, it's people that kill people. Retard.
Guns are tools.
Yeah, guns are tools. And you can have a lot of fun with them if you use them right. And you know, people say that, you know,
guns don't have any uses at all. Well, I think a gun is a lot like a car, if you think about it, because a car can be used for recreational use, such as racing and having fun, you know. But they also serve a purpose. You know, they take you places and, you know, such as, you know, they take you places and you can drive them and, you know, you can have a lot of fun. But when you're drunk and you're driving one, you have a high chance of killing someone. And at that point, you have to think, well, you know, do you blame the car for killing the person,
or do you blame
the person,
for
killing the person? Yeah.
What would you blame? What would you blame?
The person, obviously, for getting drunk. But with a gun, people say, like, oh, they don't serve a purpose. They're only for recreational use. While that may be true, they are for recreational use, they also have some benefits. They're useful, you know, you can hunt for animals with them, and, you know, you can get food.
Survival tool.
Yeah, it's a survival tool, and also for personal defense. So, banning guns is practically, is equal to banning cars. Because guns, in a sense, in a metaphoric sense, do the same thing as, you know, guns.
Yeah, no. Some ways, yes, some way.
Like, what do you mean? What do you mean, no?
Well, cars aren't used for, like, the same thing, you know?
I said metaphorically, like, cars take you places, that's useful. All right,
I thought you said, like, they always use the same, they were used the same way. I'm like,
I said metaphorically.
Yeah, I didn't hear you about that one. Sorry.
Yeah, just like, metaphorically, they're used for the same thing. They're both useful, and they're both recreational. And they both kill people if used in the wrong way. There you go, that's science and logic for you.
Yeah.
Well, not necessarily science, but mostly logic.
How do we get on this topic in the first place?
Trump.
Oh, yeah. How do we get on Trump's topic, anyway?
You said you wanted to talk about politics.
Oh. I did?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any, viewers?
Nope. No viewers, no comments.
Did you have any viewers?
The eternal commentary is not looking good so far. What?
Did you have any viewers?
Nope, never did. I've been stuck at zero viewers the whole time. I've been stuck at zero viewers for like the past four videos. Hmm? I have a dislike on which one? On the one that I'm recording right now. Let me see. Holy shit, I do have a dislike.
Who's it from?
I think it's... I don't know. Oh, I have a viewer now! I think it's... Michelle.
Who gave you the dislike?
No, who's the viewer? I don't know who gave me the dislike. It may have been the squad. I think, Walton... unsubscribed from me. Well, I had like four subs for a long time, and then I had three, and then I went back down. Yeah, I know, because I had my friends sub to me. And then I went down to three, and now I'm back up to four. But I think, the squad unsubbed for me.
I'm not gonna say that's not a good thing. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's a bad thing either.
Well, that they unsubbed for me?
Yeah.
Well, Walton is kind of an asshole. I'm gonna be completely real. Walton's a cunt. He's a total twat, dude. He's making fun of us and stuff, acting all cool. He's a cunt. Good for him that he unsubscribed. Good for you, Walton. Good for you. Go fuck yourself. I thought you were all cool until you made fun of my friend. So fuck you.
Thanks, Jason.
Yeah. So, like, they invited me to a party and I didn't join because, for one, they're annoying, for two, they're cunts, and for three,
well,
they made fun of me.
Derek Warlord is okay, I guess.
What?
Derek Warlord is okay, but...
Well, he's still a cunt.
In some ways, yes.
Yeah, I don't like him. I don't like either of them. I really do hope they die. But what topic should we talk about now? I got to finish making tea.
I don't know.
We were gonna talk about games. What about games? So, what game did you like this year?
I probably like Infinite Warfare. Modern Warfare.
Infinite Warfare and Modern Warfare? That's pretty good. I didn't like the multiplayer of Infinite Warfare. I thought the beta was okay. But it seems way too pay to win. Like, you have to buy all these variants and stuff, and there's COD points, and then the variants are, like, really OP. But I enjoyed Zombies and Campaign.
Oh, crap.
Let's talk about some more, edgy topics.
Like?
Just for example, transgender.
Do you think that it's a bad idea?
What's a bad idea?
Or do you think it's bad? I'm just asking.
He's transgender?
Yeah.
Well, I think that people who say that they're a woman who, it would, like, they're a man who say that they're a woman. I think that's BS. Because that's impossible to be a man and then also be a woman at the same time.
Well,
you see,
yes in some ways and no on the others. You know?
Well, how so? Like, how so? No.
I mean, what if you woke up one day and you thought that, say, you were a woman.
What? I couldn't hear you. Someone was talking. So, I'm a woman, I guess? What?
I mean, what if you woke up one day and you thought that and then, like, what would you do? I mean, would you just say, nah, I'm a man?
Yeah, I'm a man. I don't think I would be a woman because I am physically a man. I would not be a woman if I were physically a man.
There's some ways that people think that women have it better off. I mean, I'm not gonna say that it isn't true, but I'm also gonna say it's untrue at the same time.
Well, a lot of ways women do have it better off. Like, nowadays it's socially acceptable to make videos of just bashing white men and bashing men in general, and it's socially acceptable to do that. But if you made a video bashing, say, like, black women or women in general, you would get tons of hate.
Yeah.
And just recently, a group of black teenagers, two women, two guys, beat up a black, or beat up a white boy saying, fuck white people, fuck Trump, and they made him, they forced him to say, fuck Trump, and fuck white people. And they held him captive for over, they say, 48 hours? That's 2 days. They threatened him at knife point. Okay? They cut him. They kidnapped him. And people are saying that it's just teenagers. Teenagers do that. Okay, what if it was the other way around? Think about it. If two white men and two white women, they kidnap a black guy, they stab him, they threaten him at knife point, they kidnap him and keep him from over 48 hours and make him say fuck black people and fuck Hillary Clinton, there would be a national uproar. Not necessarily, kind of, mean it. A lot to take in, right?
What?
What I just said.
What do you mean?
Did you even hear what I said?
Kind of.
You were just not paying attention at all to what I said?
Some ways, yes.
Well, why were you not?
Because I was in the middle of the game, but...
Oh, well, the whole point of the commentary is to listen to what I'm talking about and to respond and not pay as much to the game.
I have a question. So, yeah. What does it mean to have, like, the yellow arrow?
That means, like, if you're behind cover or something, and when you aim, you'll aim to where that yellow arrow is pointing to.
How do you know if you don't have there's a gun in the area that you don't have?
It will glow yellow when you kill someone. Anyways, back to the topic that we were talking about, which was transgender. I think that when people are born as a transgender, that's not necessarily, they're not necessarily a transgender. That sounds weird because I just said that they were born with a transgender. But say, a woman born with a dick or a guy born with, you know, a vagina. That's a physical deformity. And that, you know, then it's their choice to choose whether if they are a man or a woman. It's not a perfectly normal, you know, you see normal, completely normal men and women saying that they're the opposite gender and that they're a transgender. Well, in the case, that's not, you know, that shouldn't be happening because you are the gender that you are assigned at birth unless you were born with a deformity. And people are praising it as if it's some, you know, you're a hero because you're a transgender. Fuck off. Basically, what you're saying is you're a hero because you can support, you know, disabilities or mental or like physical deformities. That's what it is. What I'm trying to say. I'm kind of having a brain fart here because I'm a little sick. But it's basically a physical deformity, and people are treating it like, oh, you're a god if you become a transgender. And that's not the case at all. Really, what they're doing is they're more being an asshole, kind of, in a way, than being a hero or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Because they're almost, in a way, using someone's deformity as a way to get attention and as a way to be known or whatever the hell, which is, in my opinion, a scummy thing to do.
Yeah.
Like, I've known people who have gone from, like, male to female or whatever. And I'm like, I don't say this to them, but I'm just like, in my head, I'm just thinking, well, are you retarded? Like, are you stupid? Are you, have you gone to school? Like, do you study science? It just baffles me how stupid people are. And the fact is that they do it for attention is even more scummy.
Some people do it for attention.
in reality, most people lose their attention. The people who change from, people who are born perfectly normal and change to the opposite gender are doing it for attention.
Yeah.
And to me, it's scummy, and it's just
kind of like,
it's
why
sad,
would you do this?
Well, not only that, but like, you're making fun of people who have a physical deformity. So to those people who say that, oh, I'm a transgender, I used to be a man, but now I'm a woman, or I used to be a woman, and now I'm a man, fuck you. Okay,
yeah.
You're doing this for attention, we all know it, fuck you. You're a scummy piece of shit. I hope you rot in hell. Gone off on a bit of a rant there, but it's a topic that I want to talk about. There's no such thing as transgender. There is male and female. No in between, no both, no neither. Male or female. And for the people who say that gender is just a social construct, why do you have to go through surgery to become the gender that you want? You have to go through surgery, dude! You have to get your dick cut off and then turned into a fucking vagina, dude!
That would not feel good.
They have, like, the numbing stuff or whatever.
Anesthesia. They put you under, but...
It's like, at this point, you have to question... This is not a social construct. You have to question whether it's a social construct or not, and it's not, okay?
Yeah, no duh.
And also, they say that there's like, what, 60-something genders now? Like, 70 genders, dude? It's like... Are you... retarded? Like, are you... Oh my, it baffles me. Like, how many brain cells do you have? Like, two? Is your IQ below, like, 10, dude? And then the people say that they're, like, both genders, like, agender, or, like, what is it? Like, non-binary? It's like, that means, like, you identify as both a man, like, both man and woman.
Yeah.
And then you can use whatever bathroom you want. So, like, some creepy old guy can say that he's non-binary and then go to the girl's bathroom. I'm not even kidding, that's happened. And, like, that's happened. And people are uncomfortable over it. I don't blame people who are uncomfortable. That shit's messed up. Ah. Yeah, I don't believe in transgenderism. I think it's fucking bullshit. I think it's stupid. I think it's retarded. People are doing it for attention, and we all know it. So what do you think about transgenders?
I really don't have a... I will die! I have to wind it up soon, but,
Okay, yeah, we're getting to the, an hour
awkward.
And 20 minutes.
Awkward point as well.
Oh, my point? Was it awkward?
Kind of.
Or do you mean, like, awkward topic?
Awkward topic.
My screen is bugging out. Well, I was just saying the point because I've seen so many people like praise these like girls who have turned into guys at like age what 13. Like what the fuck? And then and I'm just like, dude, are you kidding me? And they don't wanna say anything about it because they'll get made fun of by social justice wank bags and feminazis.
It's kind of a topic where I'm like, you know, I really have a strong opinion about it. And I'm not changing this opinion. This is gonna be my opinion for however long I live. That if you're a man, you're a man. If you're a woman, you're a woman. There's no in between, there's no both. Okay, fuck you. That's just my final point is just fuck you.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, what if you're, like, what if your dad wanted to become a girl or something?
I wouldn't support him.
Do you support him even now?
Yeah, I do, obviously, yeah, he's my dad. But I mean, if he wanted to become a woman, you know, I don't think that he should, because he was born a man, okay? This is gonna sound weird, but he impregnated my mom. That doesn't make him. I don't think he's a woman if he did that, okay? That's a weird thing to talk about, but that's the only way I can put it.
Yeah, everything's weird in life, so.
So yeah, I have a strong opinion when it comes to trans. What I think they should get is not physical health, it's mental health. I think they're sick. They, you know, they've been fed all these things. I think they're sick.
In some ways,
they've been
people
fed
like
all
this.
These lies that it's socially acceptable to become a transgender. It's like a trend now. It's like you become transgender and you're like the most popular kid in school. Like, there was this guy the other day. I posted a comment on a video, and I said, transgender people just want attention, they don't actually mean anything. And this one guy is like, I don't want attention, I simply just don't want to suffer anymore. And I'm like, you're not suffering, people in third world countries are suffering. You're suffering from is attention deprivation.
Did he actually say that?
Yeah, he actually said that he's suffering. You're not suffering.
That's
suffering
bull.
From attention deprivation. I know, it is. And this is what makes me so mad, is that people think that, you know, oh, we're
I have
suffering
to wrap it up
because,
soon.
Because people don't like us. Okay.
Like, okay, somebody doesn't like you. It's like, it's like, okay, nobody,
okay, well,
somebody doesn't like you. It's not like you're, oh my god, somebody doesn't like me anymore.
I'm suffering, I'm getting PTSD.
Fuck off. Like, I literally saw some transgender chick. She said that she has PTSD from Twitter comments.
What's PTSD?
It's like,
you don't know what PTSD, come home from battle, they have all these memories and stuff of, things that happened in the war, so they, like, reenact them or get extremely terrified.
You do not have PTSD from Twitter comments.
Exactly, like, they're saying that, oh, they're trans-shaming me, I have PTSD, feel bad for me, give me your attention, please. Fuck off.
Give like
I wouldn't give you a second of my attention. Fuck off.
Give soldiers attention. Give Marines.
They're stealing attention from soldiers. It's like they're using a soldier, you know, like, because PTSD is supposed to be like really bad, and you know, people see it as soldiers having it. And then these like SJW faggots.
What's SJW?
You know, they say that, like, social justice blank bag, social justice warrior, but, they say that, oh, we get PTSD from Twitter comments, and that's really offensive to soldiers who actually have PTSD. That's offensive to the soldiers who watch their friends die on the battlefield, so that those SJWs can keep their lives.
Yeah, they're are some just weirdos out there, and
I hope they burn.
And
I just hope they burn. I don't believe in hell.
You don't believe in God either.
I'm not religious, so I don't believe in transgenders. I don't believe in
You believe in the world.
I believe in science, and science tells me that there is no such fucking thing as transgender people. There's been multiple documents with scientists stating that transgenderism is a physical deformity and should not be praised.
I've seen some of those articles.
Yeah, I'm gonna die. Actually, I'm just gonna leave the game.
Yeah,
because
I have to leave soon,
I think it's
too.
Time. Yeah, it's time to wrap it up. What do you have to leave to?
My parents are going on that march against Trump. What?
That's funny.
What?
Why are they marching against Trump?
I don't know. They don't like
him? That's laughable. Just, in my opinion, they should just deal with it. I mean, he's president already. What's the point of protesting against him? That's ridiculous. And why do you have to go?
I'm not going.
Oh, you're not going?
No,
why
I'm staying
do you have
at a friend's house. Staying at a school friend's house.
Oh.
I wish I could have
stayed. Dude, you should have came to my house, bruh.
I couldn't. You don't go to my school.
Oh. Oh, it has to be from your school.
Nah, but I think they would. I don't know.
Yeah, I think the people who protest Trump are just butthurt that Hillary lost. It's just ridiculous, dude. It's like, okay, he's your president. Get over it. Deal with it. Suck it up. It's not going to be the end of the world. Ooh, scary Trump, the end of the world.
I mean, it would be really funny if he did make the end of the world, but it wouldn't be like, yeah, that's
people.
I'll be
people
right
have thought
down.
The end of the world. People have thought the end of the world from presidents multiple times, and guess what? It's never happened, by the way.
Yeah, I have to leave now.
Okay, well, hold on, let me end my broadcast.
Sam. See you later, guys. It's been fun.
Yeah, it's been a fun commentary. Lots of rants. Well, see you guys in the next episode of the Eternal Commentary on our new channel that we're creating called Eternal Commentaries.
Yeah.
See you guys later.
See you later.